Okay, so the meaning of this value that we all aim for is subjective. It's personal, it differs from person to person. But the rationale of seeking value from our decisions is universal. And at the center of almost all the decisions that we make in our life is the explore-exploit trade-off. Let's say you're trying to order dinner on a Saturday night in. You want pizza. You open the food delivery app and start searching for your favorite restaurant. But right then, you see a new pizza place being recommended to you. The ratings look good too. Now, what do you do? Do you go with your favorite restaurant and choose that margarita you know you love? Or do you try this new place, hoping you'll find something even better? And that is a classic example of the explore-exploit trade-off. This trade-off shows up in a lot of places. Almost every choice we make, from the day-to-day, should I wear my favorite beige or try something new? Swadesh or something new? To the long-term important stuff. Should I stay back or study abroad? Should I stay at my current job or switch?
But what is the trade-off? Why can't we just choose the options we know work for us?
Okay, let me explain.
If you always exploit, you run the risk of never finding something that could be better. And if you only explore, you give up guaranteed value in place of something which may not be as good. In either case, you're not getting the maximum value possible.
So, what do we do then?
The answer lies in balance. You need to balance the two approaches, where you explore enough to find great new things, but you also exploit enough to relish the stuff that you love.
Okay, balance, got it. But how do we know which choice to make when to get this right balance?
And that is the million-dollar question. It's what has kept mathematicians scratching their heads for over 200 years. Several algorithms have been proposed over the years, each trying to find the right balance between explore and exploit that yields the best results.
The Thompson sampling, the Epsilon greedy, the Gittins index, the Winstay, and the upper confidence bound.
But we can't use statistical algorithms when making life choices, can we? No, we can't. So let me tell you two easy strategies that you can use to make the optimal choice, or whatever comes closest to it without having to do math, which is a win anyway. The first one, seize the interval. When balancing between exploiting your favorite experiences and exploring new ones, nothing matters more than the time period for which you plan to enjoy them. This time period is the interval, and what you need to figure out is which half of the interval you're at when making the choice. When you're in the first half of the interval, it makes more sense to explore, to try out new options because you have the time to savor the best ones that you find. When you're in the second half of the interval, it makes most sense to exploit, because now you have limited chances to gain value from any new options that you do find. Let me explain. In the pizza example from earlier, let's add the variable of the time interval. On day 2, you would explore and try out the new option. On day 9, you would exploit and choose the one that you have found the best so far. The interval makes the strategy. Okay, now let's come to the second strategy, regret minimization. It's a simple strategy, really. The next time you're faced with this choice and the time interval is unclear, focus on regret. Ask yourself, will I regret not trying this new choice? If the answer is yes, then go ahead and explore. If the answer is no, then exploit away. Regret minimization is a simple yet effective strategy. Why? Because it taps into your intuition of what you believe is the choice that will bring you the most value in the short and the long run. It's also the strategy that Jeff Bezos used before he decided to launch Amazon.
I wanted to project myself forward to age 80. Looking back on my life, I want to have minimized the number of regrets I have. I knew that when I was 80, I was not going to regret having tried this. I knew that if I failed, I wouldn't regret that. But I knew the one thing I might regret is not ever having tried.
So it works. There was so much more that I wanted to share with you about this topic, which is why there might be a part two to this video. I'm not sure yet. But I hope you liked this video and found some value in it. Try identifying the next time you come across an explore-exploit trade-off in your life and let me know how it goes in the comments. I'll see you in the next one.